Okay, you all may be seated, and we're going to go into our program today. And as soon as our brother Imam, Dr. Jamal Rashid, as soon as he comes to the forefront, we'll have him take you into the message for the day. We did have another brother, Brother Alfred. He had made an express intent to try to be here, but he had problems with his health. So, you know, he was coming in from New Jersey, so he was not able to make it today. But Dr. Jamal Rashid, we have heard him speak before, and he does an excellent job. And he is doing an excellent job as usual. As-salamu alaykum.
As-salamu alaykum. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Brothers and sisters, we greet you with the greetings of peace of Assalamu alaikum. It is indeed an honor and a pleasure to share with you again some information that we hope will enliven us, to enrich us, to bring us to another level of excellence. Today is Independence Day. Many people can refer to that as a new life. Independence, a time, a new era, a liberation. In this day and time, we should have a lot of gratitude to be grateful, a time for being grateful. It's one of the themes that we hear often of the information that we have received. It is truly an honor to be alive. When you look at a lot of realities, a lot of people are stuck in prison, and we're talking about not in prison in a physical term, but imprisoned emotionally, economically, spiritually, socially, politically, culturally. The family life is in dire straits in many areas, and of course we know there are exceptions to the rule, but nevertheless, we thank Allah for guiding us and giving us some directions that hopefully we can not be a part of an imprisoned life or a restricted life or confined life, but a free life. A free life where we can truly have the tools to grow and develop and to be productive. You know, we have many people who have pretty much given up on life, who for the most part have devoted most of their time to chill time. We hear many that many of our youth refer to chill time instead of skill time. But nevertheless, we find many adults who are also confined and overwhelmed with chilling too much. In other words, they are controlled by non-productivity. And that's what the culture, a culture of death, that this culture has been defined as, a culture of death, is really earmarked towards, is trying to keep us in a non-productive mode. So we have to be aware of the schemes, the games, the plots, the tricks, the deceptions, and we know that's how Satan operates, is through deceptions, through lies, through tricks, and etc. But we cannot be duped, conned, had, hoodwinked, bamboozled by all of the destructive, deceptive tricks of mind controllers, people who are really skilled in controlling people. We've heard of enslavement. We know that our ancestors went through chattel slavery for a number of centuries. But nevertheless, when we look at our conditions today, it's not too much different from what they were doing chattel slavery. We still find ourselves in an underclass state when it comes to economic development, for example. And so that alone tells us that we have a lot to do towards independence, towards growth, towards productivity, towards being a real live people that can be proud of what we have achieved in this lifetime. You know, one of the things I would like to speak on today is reviving a honorable people to full productions again. Reviving a honorable people to full productions again. And when we describe ourselves, that is pretty much who we are, a honorable people. But we have fallen off the path of excellence through some of the schemes that I have forementioned earlier. But for centuries, many African Americans have echoed the same sentiments, attitudes, aspirations, goals, and programs that the Honorable Marcus Garvey expressed in a popular slogan, "Up, you mighty race, you can accomplish what you will." We are very proud and elated with the positive and productive aspects of our people, in spite of various religious, economic, racial, social, and political oppositions and barriers. Many African Americans, as individuals and as families, have made remarkable achievements and progress in the area of academic education and economic development. In fact, through all the abusive, disrespectful, cruel, and inhumane experiences that we have encountered, many of us have not allowed these tribulations to remove us from our natural character of being friendly and kind, humble, respectful, charitable, and demonstrating other forms of moral and human excellent behavior. Although many African Americans have made significant progress in the above-mentioned areas as a whole, we have too many African Americans who are not living up to their full potentials and expectations. As a result of these deficiencies, we are considered in some circles as sleeping giants. It is crucially important that we recognize our self-worth and abilities and diligently move forward to fulfillment and complete our purpose, objectives, and missions on this earth. We were created to not just be superb athletes, entertainers, and excellent employees to enhance corporate America's best interests. And with that, we want to stop at this point to describe pretty much who we are. You know, when we are given opportunities, we have proven in many areas that we can achieve and excel. Just look at what we have achieved when we have been given opportunities in athletics or entertainment. We are some of the best athletes and entertainers the world has ever realized. And that's with the opportunities. But what about opportunities and other avenues of development? You know, if we're given the same opportunities, we can achieve that our excellent leader, none other than President Barack Obama. That is a new era of enlightenment, where when we are given opportunities, we can achieve great heights of excellence. And that's our ability. So we have to start looking at ourselves in a different light. We're not buffoons. We're not savages that come from jungle savages and apes. That's what we grew up under, that mindset of thinking we were descendants of apes, savages, and buffoons in Africa, because we had a wrong perception of what Africa is. In fact, there are more jungles in South America than there are in Africa. And Africa is the second largest continent on this earth. So we understand that Imam W.D. Muhammad taught us that it is very important for us to be liberated. We must have the right perception. So that's one of the things that he brought us into as far as education, is coming into the right perception. And many people are enslaved and are confined and really held down because they have their wrong perception. For example, look at the tragedies mentally that people encounter when they think they were born in sin. Now, we should have graduated from that enslavement. But we see that many people have not elevated mentally. And look at the consequences when a person think of themselves in a negative perception. And so we still, many times, are walking around in this day and time, 2011, with wrong perception.